Welcome back to another Summer Life video. Now today's video is going to be about camping, cottage, and trailer. So yeah. Also, I will be making a couple of videos about camping and trailer and cottage. Like videos, or I just want to give you guys a heads up first. Now, let's get back to the video. And so, I just want to say, not everyone is like a outdoors person, but I just want to give you guys advice if you guys ever are going. So let's get started with Big Age. So depending if you are going to camping, now if you're going to camping, I suggest getting like a normal backpack, which I have used before on my very first camping trip. So yeah, and second way to bring your luggage or baggage is if you're going to your cottage or a trailer. I'm also giving as two examples. So the first example is a small baby. Now this is a very old baby that I got from my family, but you guys can buy these small babies almost everywhere. So yeah. And if you're not really a bag type of person and you're more of a kind of girl type, then you can also bring a medium sized purse. So, second thing you will need to bring is, well, hygiene stuff. So right now I have my hands tied, so you need to bring hair tie. Oops. Toothpaste and toothbrushes, but the manual ones. And and take home. Also, now I know not a lot of people really uses this, but I do, so yeah, I'm gonna show you guys. So it's a fish wash sock. This is how long this one is. Or you can get a and it's all outside. So yeah. Also talking about personal hygiene, is shampoo. Now if you're at the cottage, you can actually like get the normal store stuff ones, but if you are going to camping, either get like the little snap-on ones, which are like about this hard side, or you can get like these little bottles ones. So yeah, Also, those were just examples, so don't mind. Also, you can get the, I just want to throw in, there are smaller toothpaste, which is about a little bit smaller than this. So, if you want, can get that. So, on to the next thing. By the way, is there's stuff. Now, talking about your stuff as in phone, if you have glasses, and all that. So, what I usually bring to my trailer is obviously my tablet, my phone, which is for charging. I also bring a case, just in case. Haha, that pun wasn't even pun. Oh my god. And obviously my charger, and if you guys have a portable charger, also bring that as well. Clothes. Now I'm gonna show you guys what I'm gonna wear, what I usually wear. So, a nice, not like kind of light shirt, t-shirt, and I usually the shorts. Kind of long, high. And I usually bring leggings, but not the really thick ones. So, and if you have glasses, just like me, make sure to bring your glasses case. So yeah, glass cases kind of look like this, but a little bit, just a little bit wider, like where my hand is right there. So yeah, it's just like, but yeah, look out, something like that. Yeah, also bring your, if you have any medication, bring that with you. If you have a trailer, bring it there, but make sure it's in a safe-ish, noticeable area where everyone can see it, just in case. Yeah, also, I know, once again, not a lot of people uses this, but for my culture, which is, if you guys already haven't known, is Chinese, and we use a lot of oil stuff, which is kind of like this bottle right here, and we use oil base, whatever. So, like some iron scales, or so on. The list is very, very long, so that is just so long. Make sure you have the other this container you can buy at the dollar store, or make a DIY one with some vanilla chocolate bar case. So yeah. Next thing is, that's what's inspiring, by the way, is entertainment. Now, if you have, if kids elbows. Nowadays, kids just imagine these. So, but usually you're not allowed to, or you are, but you can't be on there time to time, so you can bring a fidget spinner or a fidget cube. You can bring it. Now, this is if you are creative and just like throwing it out. You can bring a notebook. Make sure you bring your like pencils and pens. And all of that stuff that in just here. Next thing is is going to be food. Now, if you're going camping, you can have like those little stoves, which are like little gas stoves, and you can get meat, you can get prepackaged salad, something easy-ish. Make sure to bring a cooler, and that's for both. So coolers come together, the small cooler or the bigger cooler, just like that way. And that way. So talking about coolers, ice. Now I suggest using dry ice. So because normal ice won't help, and you don't want that. For trailer and for cottage. You want something easy as well, but you can bring canned foods like soup, fish, spam, cereal, chips, crackers, cup noodles or the packet version for a couple. Now, if you guys have a working stove, oven, whatever, you can also like make other stuff as well. So, number six is drinks. Now, I suggest getting like the big packets that you guys usually get at the supermarket, or you can get the big bottles. For camping, I suggest putting it in the cooler. Also, for trailer and cottage. Now, if you're bringing milk or jeans or whatever, then pop. And if you put it in the fridge, make sure you tell someone by subconscious saying, "Hey, family member, I have this drink is under up." So, yeah. And at my old trailer, which because we didn't have really clean water, we used a big water jug, like for water, and we fill it with the sink water, so it's like already filtered. And we had a was it a hot water pot, and we poured that water without referring and into the pot and let it boil, and then we use it for cooking and drinking hot drinks. And number seven, it's no. Is going to be a hot drink. Now, if you are going to bring hot drinks, I suggest for camping, of course, buy like the little packet ones that you buy at the store, like the instant ones. So it will save you time. Also, if you are going camping, you can get those like monitor water bottles that will keep your water nice and warm. So, yeah. And for cottage and for trailer, hot drinks come in many ways. So, yeah. Just be careful. Also, for cottage, if you're gonna bring, now I don't know if you guys can do this too, but there's the teas, which are usually about like my hand plus the drink tea, so it's about this big. Teas, make sure it doesn't go on the floor. And yeah. And if you guys have like special, excuse me, tea leaves, so make sure to tell someone or have like to tell on the label as a set. For example, like this, some of the tea. So, yeah. Number eight is going to be mosquitoes. Now, for me, mosquitoes so, yeah. So, what we want to do is even or if you can, you know, if you go camping, you can get these first aid, which I have called Basica, and they have like cacao, lavender mix and smell, and it really works. I also tried the off, like little, like you put it onto your, clip it onto your, sorry, it is, clip it onto your clothes, and it's supposed to work, and kind of nervous, but not really. Now, if you live in had a cottage slash trailer, you can probably find it. Now, there are a lot of things that can for anything you can think of. So, yeah. Also, if you can't afford those things, there's a third option, which is, well, there's, you can get, like, essential oils, that's one option. The other option was, you can get, like, the fly sticky stuff, or fly ribbons, which are, like, it's very, very sticky, and if anything sticks on it, it breaks quickly. Bye-bye. So, yeah. Also, there's one more thing. You can get those, like, the zappers things. Either the hand one or the pet ones. So, they're kind of okay, guys. But, yeah, just give you guys all the good stuff. So, the next thing we're going to fill in shirts. For camping in trailer, I don't know if that's still a thing, but perhaps. Rounded shoes. Sneakers, very comfortable sneakers. Socks, well, you can wear waterproof shoes, like for like going into like water. Also for cottage slash trailer, you can now, I don't know if you've seen this before, but you have to take off your shoes and then a harness and then slippers. Slippers. It can be any kind of slippers. It can be the normal sliding shoe slipper, flip flops. So, yeah. So, I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I hope you guys will like the other cottage slash camping life video, and I know I haven't said everything that you need, but these are some things that I either have done or I done throughout my life. So yeah, comment down below if you guys like camping or not, because I'm okay with it actually. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.